Hello everyone, my name is Arshan and welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'll be showing you how to convert text to speech using a very simple package called Google Text to Speech and creating a very simple function to hear that speech. So this is a very basic tutorial on you can, when you just type a text and if you want to hear that text the same exact way where you hear when you type it on Google and you want to hear that out, you want to hear the pronunciation of that text, it's going to be the same exact voice here because we're using the Google Text to Speech CLI, command line interface from the GTTS API, all right? So it's the exact same thing. It's available in Python. And, if you want to create a very cool app or, if you're doing some audio pre-processing, this is quite useful. So let's quickly get into it. So in this, the first thing you need to do is install this package. You need to go to an Anaconda prompt or your command prompt and then type pip install GTTS. Make sure you do this as an administrator. And for me, it's already done and the requirement is already satisfied, it shows here. But for you, it might take a couple of minutes or so if you haven't done it already. And then let me just explain you this code and I'll just run the whole line. So I've just imported the two important libraries, GTTS, and this ipython.display is just gonna create I've imported audio, which is going to create an audio file and save that in this particular file name, that is temp_file.wav. It's the WAV, is basically the MP3 format. And I'm gonna create a function. Now this is the most interesting part. Like here, I'm creating a function where I'm going to be taking input and the file name as my arguments, and I'm going to objectify them using the TTS, using a variable called TTS, and I'm going to use the dot save, which is from the GTTS module, this dot save function, and this GTTS which you see here, this particular thing, that's the thing that is actually going to show us the audio. All right, so this function is very understandable. We're just objectifying it, we're saving it in the file name. We need to save it because we need to return that audio. Okay, so we have imported this audio and we've used this file name because we need to return that audio. So we need to save it. And after returning that, after clicking on return audio, it's gonna bring that particular file name and our recorded text. Okay, and I've put autoplay is equal to true here because if I put autoplay is equal to false, I have to do an extra step and click on this play button, which I don't want to. So I'm just gonna put autoplay is equal to true. And here's my text. So let me just quickly run this entire code and show you what exactly is gonna go on. Now you're gonna probably hear something from the desktop. Let me just run this.
Hello everyone.
There you go. So let me just type a very complicated word. Let's type let's type Sagittarius.
Sagittarius.
Oops, I used caps. my bad, sorry. Sagittarius.
Sagittarius.
Oh, that's how it's pronounced. Okay, that's interesting. So yeah, let us type something else and see there was. Just give me a minute.
Please subscribe to support my channel.
Yeah, there you go. So as you can see, it's very simple. You can use it for creating an application, or you can just use it to impress your friends, really. If you're just got into coding, you're just a beginner software engineer, if you're a guy who's in preschool or something, or high school, you can still do this. So this is a quick tutorial. I hope you like the video, and please do subscribe to my channel to motivate me to make more videos. That'll actually motivate me to make more videos. And if you have any query, just leave it in the comments. And until next time. Cheers.